So we got the microphone's good. Got the audio working. All right. What's up, everybody? It's all Sunforge for Dungeons and Taverns. How's everybody doing? Haven't seen you for quite some time. Or it feels like it anyway, you know. But I'm gonna shave today. I'm getting a razor kit in the mail. Hopefully, it's supposed to arrive today. We'll see if it does or not. I can trim myself up real good. Anyway, so before the session, I added some name tags in some places, and you know, I wanted to remind myself certain things that I want to do, certain zones, or to look certain things up with you. I decide that, you know, I want to take the extra time to look things up with you, just because I know what certain terms may be, you know, doesn't mean that you might, you know. And so I kind of want, you know, this to be educational as well. And so we might not be able to do videos, even though it's under fair use for educational purposes. It would be perfectly fine for me to do that. However, in real life, in a YouTube, that doesn't matter. They don't care about the law, you know, or, you know, your rights. And so we're going to go ahead and just maybe show you pictures, or perhaps maybe bring up articles of some of these things, okay? And I'm not gonna, I might not go over every single one with that fine tooth comb, but I probably will. I don't know yet. But I wrote down a few places that I wanted to cover. Riparian wetlands was a big one that I wanted to cover. Bogs. And then freshwater forest and swamp is some stuff I wanted to really cover. Mangroves. And so we're gonna hit these areas up, at least for this video. You know, and there's a good chance maybe the next video too, I don't know. Because I learned how to do something with Incarnate that I didn't know how to do before. And I'm actually pretty excited to use it in certain places and see what type of difference it does make. All right. So the first one we will mess with is the Riparian wetlands. Let me move the sequoias out of the way, because they're going to go over here, more or less. So we'll just put them over there for right now. That's going to be the largest concentration of sequoias on the map, I believe, is going to be this. Believe. I do love me some sequoias. I really do. Alright. So, a riparian wetland is area of land just outside of a river, basically a riverbank, that floods, like, say, along the Nile, for instance. A lot of that area would be classified as riparian wetlands. And so when the area floods along the riverbed, there's nowhere for that water to go. And so that is a great place for rice. Rice paddies. That is perfect, because, you know, it's not man-made, and so you know, it's not destructive to the environment in any way. It's part of the environment. So you're, it's just, you know, I feel like it's better. And so we're going to make this area here riparian wetlands because there's two rivers. And this one right here is probably more likely to flood, especially with that wicked ass bend. So we're going to give this area the most fertile looking grass. And we're going to probably have to change some grasses around. I just really love green, and I think it just shows up amazing on the map. So, you know, you'll see me playing with lots of different green colors. Now, green phthalates. Yeah, so you type blue phthalates instead of just getting a color light and having to mess with it to get it to be that color. Okay. Yeah, that's a pretty good texture. We want it to be what size? Maybe size 20? Because I want to see if it shows the elevation differences or no. Wait, why is it at size 500? What the heck? Yeah, I was going to say, what the heck? But that was a pretty sweet green. I'm wondering if I should do something with this little land mass here. Just leave this one island. Yeah, I think I'll just leave the one there. Change. We haven't messed with rivers or anything for a long time. It's about time we do that. Yeah, that's cool. So that's what the riparian wetlands are. That's where the rice is going to be from. The major export of rice in the world is going to be from this area. So it's going to have a huge economy impact on rice prices. They're pretty much going to control, be rice barons. I like that story. I like that. Alright, so these right here are called mangroves. Okay, and I'll move that term down here. But this is mangroves. And what a mangrove is the silt that's deposited from a delta. What silt is, right? It's like, you know, fine nutrient dense deposits, dirt that comes down the river, you know, from the river naturally flowing. Well, that dirt eventually deposits into areas and creates these little tufts of land, because eventually as they build up taller and taller, then they start getting drier and actually hot, you know, cement themselves as little islands as time goes. Well, a mangrove is when they've been there long enough that their vegetation is trees. So it's not just, you know, little bushes and grass and things like that. It's actual trees. So these deltas have been there for a very long, exceedingly long time. And what I'm going to do for this mangrove here is I'm going to make those trees sequoias, the king tree. And so that means these are ancient, because sequoias take forever to get that tall. So this delta has been here for thousands of years. So if the players happen to need anything to do with sequoias, or have quests to see druids that are down in the sequoias, and that's the only place that those druids are in the world, you know, the players, you'll see some sequoias. I'm pretty excited, if you can't tell. I'm very excited about this campaign. I hope you guys are too. And, you know, I appreciate you watching me build the maps. And, you know, I feel like it's a privilege for you to come along with me on this journey. You know, it's my privilege, not yours. It's my privilege. I'm very excited to show off what I do and what I make. And, you know, this is like a major in-depth look into things. And, you know, I might not get down to the nitty-gritty details of the inner workings of cities, but, you know, I'll put the cities and, you know, some generalizations about their population and things, maybe. You know. Later on down the line, though, I do plan on making a Patreon to go step-by-step in detail, elaborate detail for every little aspect on how from A to Z on how to make your campaign, every little thing covered, and then additional optional things, and I'll have everything covered. And you know, I might make map packs for that stuff too. That'll come later, though. I like to sneak in little details into these videos for as rewards for people who watch them. All right, so I decided right before I started recording that I didn't like this mountain range here. It doesn't really feel natural. This, however, does. And so I'm going to get rid of it. Make a little point there. That's pretty sweet. Make a little point. So it still kind of separates it, but you know, it's not like as crazy as having the mountain range there. Just a little point. All right. So because of that, we're going to do both desert sides on this side. Put the savanna up here, I believe. Because we're gonna look prairie pothole is the one we're gonna look up. We'll look up savanna too. But let me move them real quick though around. Or not real quick, but you know, quicker. All right, let's go with sand. Light and then dark. All right, so no, it doesn't look. No, it doesn't look the same. All right, so let's go to desert. No, none of those look like it. Was it under sand? This one. There we go. That's it. And the lighter sand is up here because it's closer to water. That's my theory. The darker the sand, the drier it's supposed to be. That's my theory. I mean, I don't know if that makes sense to you or not. Let me know in the comments if you think it does. I'm always interested in everybody else's thoughts. Like, I really want to know what you guys think about my stuff. It's important to me. Okay, so we got that. Let's see, grassland. And we're going to do some different stuff with the grassland, but, you know, we were kind of just more or less laying down some stuff. I'm not sure if I like the way these receive water. I don't know if I like this. I mean, I like the waterfalls, but I don't know if I want it. I don't know if I want it forming essentially three ponds. We'll get to it. It's taxing, isn't it? It's rewarding, but it's taxing. So let's do grass. grassland. No, we don't want to do grassland. That's pretty fertile grass. Although this one looks pretty cool. We might redo it. Yeah. This would be fertile grass. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, I love it. It's transforming it. Just at the same time, some chimes drop on the music. That's cute. It should only be fertile up until this point. And then over here, it should be less so. Until it fades into the desert. Does that sound cool? Fish colored in this grass here. What was that supposed to be? Path? Or was it? Was that the? That was the sand. I believe, if I remember right, this area is actually sand. It is. It's actually sand. A really soft sand, though. Yeah. That area right there is sand. Up to that hill right there. And then alright, so back to the problem that we were having. It's not really a problem, but the original task . Sorry, we're getting down to the nitty-gritty, you know, so want to make improvements when I see him. I think I'm going to use that grass texture for my pine forest too. Grass dry. Yeah. Yeah, that does look like dry grass for sure. More so than what I had before. Maybe down in the valley, you can have a little bit, you can keep that grass. It would be on this side too. And we're going to look up Prairie Pothole here shortly. I mean, that's like the color of the grass around here, pretty much in the summer. Color all that for now. Yeah, that grass texture is pretty sexy. What happened to the music? Alright. It was weird. It didn't stop, but I couldn't hear it. Lovely grassland. They're going to really enjoy having their property over there. Prospecting and securing those with soldiers, and yeah, it's gonna be sweet. It's gonna be sweet. look up both. We'll look up both of those, actually. That's fine. Prairie pothole. Prairie potholes are depressional wetlands, primarily freshwater marshes, found most often in the upper Midwest, especially North Dakota, South Dakota, Wisconsin, and Minnesota. This formerly glaciated landscape is pockmarked with an immense number of potholes, which fill with snowmelt rain in the spring. Some prairie pothole marshes are temporary, while others may be essentially permanent. Here a pattern of rough concentric circles developed. Submerged and floating aquatic plants take over the deeper water in the middle of the pothole, while bulrushes and cattails grow closer to the shore. Wet, sedgy marshes lie next to the upland. Alright, I won't read everything about it to you, but that's the description. Alright, so based off of this description, we need to move it. We're going to move our prairie potholes. Because according to the description, the prairie potholes, look at that. Look at this. It's already started. Alright. So, we'll just do a few. See how it looks. Cool. Is it a good amount? Sweet. And of course, when we go down to the regional, then we'll add the plants and all that stuff. We're not going to do that in the world map because it doesn't, you know, it doesn't make sense. All right, so we have the prairie potholes where they're supposed to go. Of that article. Let's go back over there because there's other things we're going to look up. Temperate grassland. Alright. So let's go to the Google machine. lake savannas, temperate grasslands are areas of open grassland with very few trees. Temperate grasslands, however, are located in colder climate regions and receive less precipitation on average than savannas. Okay. Temperatures in temperate grasslands vary according to the season. In winter, temperatures can plummet to well below 0 Fahrenheit in some areas. In summer, temperatures can reach above 90. Temperate grasslands receive low to moderate precipitation on average per year. So that makes sense for it to be next on the other side, just on the other side of the desert. That makes perfect sense. But now the savanna has to get moved. Alright, see how we're doing it? Alright, so now that means the savanna has to go. That's not where it's at, but I'm moving with it. Wherever I decide to put the desert at on this section. I don't remember if this was the final place in my desert or if I was going to, or was this where I forget. We gotta decide where we're putting the desert on this side, because there has to be one. I will it. I command it. Fertile. So for this would be the savanna. If this is the savanna, then this would be the desert. We're probably gonna do something about the mountains too. Like, which way they're facing and all that kind of things. I just got a good idea. I don't know. Is that too soon? Shoot. That might be too soon. Okay, so we're here. You'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. I don't want to explain it just yet. You'll see why I'm excited. Thank you. might be too sharp. I'm really enjoying this music, I gotta say, it's rather hauntingly beautiful. Hopefully you're enjoying the stream, man. I really enjoy doing this stuff for you guys, you know. And, you know, it's my hope that eventually, here soon, there's more, more folks, like-minded individuals to join you. That'd be very awesome. Is that still too? I think we're all right. Would the cold from the north come down further over here because it's open? Think of moving this down. Moving this, these things down. I'll think about it. Looks like it's going through it. Why would you not cast shadows as mountains? Oh my God. Thank you. But either way, small. What's going on with this music? Those aren't small. A little bit smaller, there we go. Thank you. take some time. Freshwater forest and swamp. I think I want to move that. The freshwater forest and swamp would be like. Where would I put that? Right here? With this waterway in between? Or would I widen it out so that the waterways all split off of it? What happened to the music? Let me go fix the music. Alright, I think the music should be back. Yeah, there it is. I don't know, it was acting like my internet was failing or something, but hopefully it's not. I need to replace my motherboard, and I'm switching from Intel to AMD, and I'll be doing that here shortly. I got my tools and everything. I'm good to go. I got everything I need. So we're looking at moss. Do I have a moss color? Sweet. Definitely looks like moss to me. I love it. Ba-da-da-da-da-da. Alright, so let's shrink this. So we dealt with it. So this way, when I finalize the map for the players, what I'm naming, because each area is going to be named thoroughly. You know, some swamps, the bogs, you know, lakes, rivers, you know, those things are renamed, so the players can refer back to them easy. Wetland, no trees. Alright, so let's look at marsh. What is a marsh? A marsh is a wetland that is dominated by herbaceous rather than woody plant species. Marshes can often be found at the edges of lakes and streams, where they form a transition between aquatic and terrestrial ecosystems. They're often dominated by grasses, rushes, or reeds. If woody plants are present, they tend to be low-growing shrubs, and then sometimes called carrs. This form of vegetation is what differentiates marshes from other types of wetlands, such as swamps, which are dominated by trees, and mires, which are wetlands that have accumulated deposits of acidic peat. Have any mires? Absorb high tides. Dark. White. wonderful looking green. I like that. I do like that. It has a Super Nintendo map quality look to it. I love that a lot. So, in this case, if the world map shows that there's a marsh there, the world map might actually have a decorative shrub or two. Plants. Leaf plants. I want to make herbs that only grow in wetlands and stuff. I'm fully blowing out my professions for the next campaign. You're gonna love it. If you watch it, you're gonna love it. Is a type of peat accumulating wetland fed by mineral-rich ground or surface water. It is one of the main types of wetlands along with marshes, swamps, and bogs. Bogs and fens, both peat-forming ecosystems, are also known as mires. The unique water chemistry of fens is a result of the ground or surface water input. Typically, this input results in higher mineral concentration and more basic pH than found in bogs. As peat accumulates in a fen, groundwater input can be reduced or cut off, making the fen ombrotrophic rather than minerotrophic. I'm not sure what those words mean. I don't usually come across things I don't know what they mean. In this way, fens can become more acidic and transition to bogs over time. Fens can be found around the world, but the vast majority are located at the mid to high latitudes of the northern hemisphere. They're dominated by sedges and mosses, particularly graminoids that may be rarely found elsewhere, such as the sedge species. Fens are highly biodiverse ecosystems and often serve as habitats for endangered or rare species, with species composition changing with water chemistry. They also play important roles in recycling of nutrients such as carbon, nitrogen, and phosphorus due to the lack of oxygen in waterlogged organic fen soils. Alright. So, the fen would not be there because the fen is supposed to be more north. Hopefully I spell, spell this right. Zones. Low desert, far north presents challenges for this, sequoias. Drained, permanently swampy. Well, it's not per, maybe it's not permanent. The fen is impermanent. Boom, sequoias. I hope you like learning about these environments as much as I do. I freaking love it. I love the different biomes. Like, it's so amazing. Like, if you just look up the different biomes, it gives you so many ideas, or it should give you at least a few ideas on things that you can run in your own camp. Maybe not even the whole thing. Maybe I should reduce the size. that looks swampy there. That's nice. That looks like shit to travel through. Can you imagine traveling through that on a hot day? How stinky it would be, and the mud just slurping on your shoe. The bugs. Oh my gosh, giant mosquitoes. Let's try it. It's probably not going to be to the edge, but just for right now, that's where I have it. That's pretty sweet. All right. What is a peat sink? Are a type of wetland which are critical for preventing and mitigating the effects of climate change, preserving biodiversity and minimizing flood risk, ensuring safe drinking water. Peatlands are the largest natural terrestrial carbon store. They store more carbon than all other vegetation types in the world combined. Damaged peatlands are a major source of greenhouse gas emissions, blah blah blah. Every country known to occur at least 3% of global land surface. Peat soil and the wetland habitats are growing on the surface. Year-round waterlogged conditions slow plant decomposition. So something like a little, like, sort of like a... not quite Louisiana, but I don't think Florida either, really. Somewhere in between there, maybe. Make this the peat sink. That might make more sense. And we know there's peat and coal there as the resources. I'm keeping track of that for me for later. I'm just doing the work now, since I'm already going through this, you know. Let's go ahead and change the size down to like 15. Put a little bit of touches here on the shore. This is just exactly what I envisioned too. There's gonna be somebody over here capitalizing on this too, I think. Alright, so then we're gonna have to change this up to something else. What type of plants grew in a fen? The peat accumulating root. Yeah. And groundwater is how we're feeding this one. it's not a sewer, but kind of fits in. Hills would actually be over on this side. a bog. A bog or bogland is a wetland that accumulates peat, deposit of dead plant material. Often mosses, and in the majority of cases sphagnum moss, is one of the four main types of wetlands. Other names for bogs include mire, mosses, quagmire, and muskeg. Alkali mires are called fens. A bagel is another type of bog found in the forests of the Gulf Coast states in the United States. They're often covered in heath or heather shrubs, rooted in the sphagnum moss and peat. Bogs occur where the water at the ground surface is acidic and low in nutrients. Most of their water comes from precipitation. Freshwater marsh. I remember that was when we had to look up. But alright, so we have the fen. The fen is settled. And it has peat and coal. And, you know, we've seen that several times. Peat, moss. The coal. The pressure, the immense pressure of the of all the things that are that can't decompose, is what's creating coal. So this place has high deposits of coal. We'll see who or what is making use of those, or if it's causing conflicts to get to those as resources. All right, and so what is the swamp? Swamp outside New Orleans, Louisiana, rich in plant and animal life. Yes, that's what I think about when I think of a swamp. A lot of those sweet, those droopy trees. They look like weeping willows, but I don't think these ones are. But that's what they look like to me. That's what swamp trees look like. Swamps in an area of land permanently saturated or filled with water. Many swamps are even covered by water. There are two main types of swamps, freshwater swamps and saltwater. Swamps are dominated by trees. They're often named for the type of trees that grow in them, such as cypress swamps or hardwood swamps. Freshwater swamps are commonly found inland, while saltwater swamps are usually found along the coastal areas. Okay, and then I think I made a note. Oh yeah, freshwater forest and swamp. In the north is red maple, and in the south is Atlantic white cedars. So, happen if we... Still look wet. Even though there's no like water signs present. There we go. Alright, that's pretty cool. That's pretty good. The rice patty patches, I want to do different. I think it's like field or something. I don't know. It's one. Yeah. Those are fine. But I want to do. So I want to do water also though. So we'll see. But this is a rather huge section to grow rice. Even, you know, it is the only section that supplies it for the world. It's still quite big. The world is rather fortunate. guess there isn't one. We'll do one more. Freshwater marsh. Freshwater marsh is a non-tidal, non-forested marsh wetland that contains fresh water and is continuously or frequently flooded. Freshwater marshes primarily consist of sedges, grasses, and emergent plants. Freshwater marshes are usually found near the mouths of rivers, along lakes, and are present in areas with low drains like abandoned oxbow lakes. It is the counterpart to the salt marsh, an upper coastal intertidal zone of biohabitat, which is regularly flush with seawater. Highly productive, it can support large biodiversity and vegetation. Immersion plants, floating plants, floating leaves, submerged, primary plant, freshwater marshes, soft stems. Cattails, water lilies, arrowheads, and rushes. So soil from freshwater marshes can be processed out for gardening. Oh yeah. Very rich nutrient soil. Regularly flooded plain. How do I show that it's regularly flooded without making it constantly flooded on the map? Like, how do I show the appearance? This would work, what I did over here. Because it looks like, you know, water regularly comes in here. All right. Well, actually a pretty good long video. We'll put the freshwater marsh over here next time. We'll remember it's flooded, so we'll have to change that up. We got 281 changes in today, which is pretty good. It's a pretty good session. We made some good positive changes, for sure. And we're getting closer to finishing this up. If you made it to the end of the video, let me stop the music here. If you made it to the end of the video, I very much appreciate you. You're the type of warrior that I'm looking for on my channel. And so I'm looking for you to help me grow. If you could let people know about my channel and let people know the type of content that I make and that you appreciate it, maybe we can find some more like-minded individuals to come in here. And I appreciate all the support and love that you give me. Second off, this map here is going to be for a project that I'm making. I'm going to be doing some stop motion with figurines. I'm getting a 3D printer, and I used to paint Warhammer, so I'm going to be a little bit rusty, but I'm going to be painting the minis for D&D, and we're going to be filming. And this is the world that I'm making right now. This is the world that that's going to be in. And, so you're getting a sneak peek of that. And you're getting that bombshell right there. So that's to let you know that I appreciate you. Chew on that a little bit. I'm not going to guarantee a date at this time when that will be ready. Just that it's in the works. It's in the initial stages. But it is a firm, solid idea. One of a few. For the future of this channel. Just one of the programming options that you'll be able to find here. So, I salute you for watching this far. Thank you so much. And have yourselves a great day.